And welcome to The Vote. And tonight I'm joined by Ed Wilson from the Sussex University Conservative Society and George Taylor, you might have seen quite a bit on our screens. He's also a Liberal Democrat.
Of course.
So I'm really joined by the Coalition, 2010 Coalition, and they've joined together tonight. We're going to look at the last year, 2017, and the year of 2018. We're particularly going to look at local politics, and we're going to also then look at that B word as well a bit later on. But let's start with local. You're quite strong locally, Ed. You know, you've got a good leader, I think, Tony Janio and Lee Wears and people like this.
Well, I mean,
what's your perception of the local Conservative councillors?
There's definitely improvements being made, but that being said, I think I've had interactions with both Tony and Lee, and I think they're fantastic guys who've got good intentions for the city. They love the place, absolutely love it. I think one issue they have is social media, and they know that. And they know there's an issue with the youth, and that's why they're trying to talk to us, the members of society, and actually try and push us in a direction where we can help them out. They're giving us a lot of support, and we're giving them support.
They were quite strong, weren't they, on Uber? They didn't want Uber, and Labour seemed to be shilly-shallying around it a bit. What's your perception of Uber? What's your view, too?
I love Uber. It's the market providing a service, which is something else can't. I mean, one thing I like, it's so easy to just Uber, done. Yeah. It's cheap, it's efficient, and it's benefits the consumer.
What do you think about the local taxi companies? Obviously, it's not benefiting them. And also, what about all the assaults and stuff that Uber have allegedly been responsible
for? Well,
most recently this week.
That's the thing.
With a British diplomat.
It's all alleged, and these things are being made to make this company a horrible company, vilify everyone. But I've never had a bad experience. And I'm saying that as someone who's used Uber, not just in this country, but all over Europe.
Yeah.
And outside of Europe.
Sounds like you might disagree a bit with your leadership on that one. What about other issues? You know, what issues do you disagree with the local Conservative? Well, ones do you agree with?
I think the one thing is obviously the local parties support the manifesto and they try to push it in that way. And as we all know, I'm a very big critique of the Conservative Party, despite being a Conservative, because I believe I'm a very strong Conservative. That being said, I know that Lee's a very good, strong Conservative as well. I don't really know too much about the local issues and what they stand on, but I know that they do care about the city, and that's one thing that's nice to see. And I think it's very important that they emphasise the compassionate side of conservatism, and instead of going hard and cutting and so much more, it's to justify and try to spin these things to make it look like we're conservatives, but we're not here, this is a nasty party, to punish everyone. Mm. We don't want to punish aspiration, we don't want to punish those who are the lowest of conditions, but we want to actually raise standards and actually benefit, because they're listening to us as a society. And recently I had to fill out a paper to discuss the party itself on what issues affect us as youth. Yeah. I wrote it for our society. And one issue is like raising standards for like youth housing.
We'll come on to that in a minute, okay. I think that was largely your manifesto, not really the Conservative Party, if I might say. George, there isn't much of a local Liberal Democratic Party here at all. I wanted you to say is, what are you doing to make sure there is one? And also, what's your view on the leadership, on Warren Morgan? Because obviously, I can't ask Ed at the moment. I've got to ask him about people he's already got, on the council.
Well, we have a 500-strong local party. We are there.
Who are the main figures on that?
Well, we've got Carrie Hydes.
Okay.
We've got Michael Willoughby, who's now exiting our chair, and we've got David Kingston coming in. We've got Paul Chandler, who has stood for a couple of elections, and Ola May. These are big ones who are still there and is still pushing. And we are still...
Does George Taylor have any ambitions that way?
Of course. I think anyone who starts into politics, if they don't have ambitions to become part of the hierarchy in the party...
I'll be asking you in a minute. Okay.
If you don't have any ambitions to become the best you can best and become an MP or Prime Minister, you're not...
What
really
about
prime.
Warren Morgan and the way he's led the local Labour Party and the way he's led the local council? What's your view?
Well, we hear a lot about May, but... Well, what about Morg? But he is possibly one of the it's hard to explain because he just doesn't have passion. It feels like he's lost passion. And with all of this that's going on with the momentum and people rumouring that he's going to stand down for leader.
Who's saying that?
Well, it's been circling around. I believe there's been calls quite recently for him to step down as leader. So I believe it's not getting to him too much, but you can definitely see it's there in his mind. He's thinking about it.
He's had a big success with the Dear Arches, has he not?
Well, I actually went door knocking in the Madeira area.
Yeah.
And the main thing that came up was Madeira terraces, because it's not getting built straight away. Yeah. There is, well, we've had this crowdfunding, but apparently that's not enough. There was never this.
I think that's three arches out of 150.
Yeah. What? It's why did they lie to the people though? But that's. Did you ever see that in the text? Did you when we were seeing these pushes, the pushes for the crowdfunding? Did you ever say, "Oh, but you only get three arches, not all of them."
Right. Okay.
That's. You can't just lie to the people like that. That's not right.
I don't think he lied. I think that might be pushing it a bit strong. Warren Morgan and the local Labour leadership, and the way you get on with them in, you know, because often you're voting on the same sides.
Yeah, I know. I mean, that's the beauty of local,
isn't it?
Local government, really. You side with everyone who you really want to, really. I mean, you have to vote for some things. It's a lot more cooperative and beneficial, but you have to do these things in order to get other things passed. It's all this.
So how do you see him doing? He's obviously got momentum.
I see, like, you know, from my understanding, he seems to be more of the Blairite side of politics.
Yeah.
Obviously, that's the side of politics that I prefer, and I know the Conservative Party would rather him as leader than anyone else, because he's stable, he knows what he's doing. He might not be the most passionate person, but he's doing a decent job. And obviously, we'd rather have him, a Blairite, than a momentum-led Labour Party, because a momentum-led Labour Party within Brighton would be one which absolutely ruin everything and could possibly move people who are very aspirational out, which is tax revenue.
The local elections are not for a year and a bit, are they?
They're not, but you see, though, in local elections, you're seeing now in local councils that the momentum are purging and they're not taking any victims. They're taking, not being polite, they're just taking everyone that doesn't agree with them, which goes back to the previous episode where I said it's either momentum or you're out, and I think that's very wrong with the Labour Party, because you have diverse opinions.
If the Tories stay in power, the usual way is, you know, Brighton usually goes Labour, you know, with Tories in power. If Labour was in power, it would probably be Tory. So in 2019, we are likely to have a Labour council, you know, probably quite a strong Labour council. Is that a worry for you, if Warren is replaced?
It would be a worry for me, because I don't want a momentum-led Labour Party. But that being said, I don't think we should underestimate the Conservative Party at the moment, because the links they're forging with us as a society on campus, and the amount our membership is, to say it's doubled is an understatement. It's skyrocketing. And, I mean, we're getting a lot of attraction from the party itself. And if you're getting the youth out, young Conservatives saying, "We vote for us," it's going to show a real passion and something that's been seen all across youth politics. And I think that might actually change a lot of things. But I do think that Labour may win. But that being said, I think the Conservatives are going to do well.
George?
Well, when I went to the full council meeting, I was actually more supporting the Greens and the Conservatives. I mean, I've had the opportunity to interview the councillor, Joe Miller, who was just one of the nicest guys I've ever met.
He's Green, yes.
No, Joe Miller's a Conservative.
He's Conservative.
Yes, I've also interviewed Leo Lim, the Green one. But I don't see Labour doing that well. That's the thing, we see momentum pushing a lot. Yeah. But I believe if there is... if Lib Dems, the Greens and the Conservatives can all just put out the one message of momentum... The problem is we don't know what's going to happen in a year's time.
What's wrong with momentum? They seem to have... On paper, it looks good. It looks like we're going to have no food banks. It looks like people are going to be who are the lower down on the sort of income scale are going to rise up. It looks like the big companies will be taxed. So it all sounds quite good. What's wrong with that?
When you don't think you're going to get into power, you can say what you like. And I think the Lib Dems...
You don't believe them?
I don't believe a single thing they say.
Okay.
Because, we saw the Lib Dems, we said a lot, and then we managed to get into coalition.
Fees.
Yeah. It was that famous photo.
Yeah.
And when you get to coalition, you don't know what you're going to say.
Okay. And why don't you like momentum?
Let's just say, if momentum to get into power, I'd probably leave the country. I've said this: if Jeremy Corbyn becomes prime minister of the country, I'd leave the country without a doubt.
I would
finish my education at Sussex University and I'd go elsewhere, because I don't think that it's a country which provides aspirations. I think that huge increase on income taxes for those in the lower middle class will push them even more.
How much do you think... you're talking about people earning, 70,000, 60,000?
70,000 is a household. I mean, but bear in mind... Lower middle class, they always like that. They're talking about increasing income tax, increasing VAT.
Couldn't it be income tax for people earning 100,000, 150,000 and... in the 70s,
it's going to
90%
it's going to borrow a ridiculous amount, and you borrow again, it means Conservatives go back in power, they can't cut, and we continue the cycle.
Didn't we have a wealth tax or a land tax on people who own half the country?
A land tax isn't good though, because you've got houses which ridiculously rise in price, which means that those who have inherited a house or may have been fortunate enough to buy a house, like, say, imagine buying a house in Brighton 20 years ago. Okay. How much is that house worth now? There's a guy that, an old electrician that came to my house, student house last year, his father bought his house, I think 60 odd years ago, for a ridiculously low price. That house is now worth 1.2 million. He's just lucky enough to live in it, buy a house and look after it for so many years. He doesn't matter what he's earning. He's just been lucky, fortunate enough to have this. You shouldn't just be taxing housing, stuff like that, because it's just tax, 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 tax.
Housing's obviously a huge issue.
Yeah.
We're going to take a little break now, and in the second part of the show, we're going to talk all about housing in Brighton. And welcome back to The Vote, and I'm joined by Ed Wilson from the Conservatives, George Taylor from the Liberal Democrats. We're looking at the last year, 2017, and the year coming, 2018, and we're trying to avoid that B word. Amazing, isn't it? You won't hear much of that on this channel anyway. I think there are big social issues that people are just not discussing. We've been discussing them. Perhaps the biggest one of all is young people and housing. It's beginning to get a little attention, but not much. Most young people can hardly afford to rent, never mind buy. Ed, what are you going to do about it? You are a Conservative.
Yeah,
you are young. Aren't you really mad at your government for doing nothing about this?
Well, indeed I am. I mean, I'm going to specifically talk about students in this next bit. One thing is the maintenance loan. The maintenance loan is going to be is the same for everyone except for those in London. They get a bit more because London is a very expensive place to live. But someone who, say, like Hull, will get the same. If they had the same income, parents' income as I do, get the same amount of money as I would get in Brighton. And Hull, you can get a house for £75, £80, and they'll consider that expensive a week. Mm. Over here, I'm paying £140. And I mean, that's over a week. And so that's not including bills.
Nearly 600 quid.
It's £600 a month. Mm. And that's not including bills. And I mean, that's not even the most expensive I've heard. And I mean, luckily enough, I've got a house which is in very high condition. But that being said, I mean, it's ridiculous. There's a clear disparity. What I'd do is change how taxes are, income taxes, because I think, you should, like I said before, you should be able to support yourself, pay your bills before you pay tax. You don't owe the government anything. If you're working, you should be able to support yourself and those around you. And then you should be able to pay, contribute to society. Because what's the point of contributing to society if you're going to cripple yourself and rely on government?
I know, you're at Sussex University.
Yes. I am indeed.
Yeah, there was a big case, wasn't there, that we followed here on Latest TV over the last few weeks about a number of students who were in, I think, a university-owned building.
Indeed.
And they went on rent strike. In the end, the university paid up a lot of money.
64,000.
That was largely Acorn were to do with that. And Acorn are an offshoot of sort of the left. Yeah. Offshoot of Momentum, I think, Novara and people like this. I mean, you're obviously in bed with them. That's pretty unusual.
Yeah, I know, but I think the thing is, though, when you're in university, I'm not saying you have the best conditions of houses, but when you have... this is Britain, for heaven's sake. I mean, don't get me wrong. Like, we should expect some decent housing. My girlfriend, she's Swedish, and she says about the Swedish... When Swedes come over to the UK, they look for a Swedish-style house, and that's essentially a house which has got quality in it. Because they believe that British housing standards have fallen quite dramatically. And I mean, this case was like...
IKEA should build homes.
Well, yeah.
I mean, they might be out in Lansing, I heard this week, then, well, they're selling an IKEA store and there's a deal with lots
said,
of homes.
Like, a house shouldn't... You should be able to provide the very basics. You shouldn't be having damp in there. There shouldn't be having holes in the walls. There shouldn't be animal infestations. It's ridiculous. And I'm very proud that these students have gone... We are not taking it, and we're going to take action. And I'm very proud that Acorn have done a very good job.
You're young, and obviously you've got strong views on it. Maybe that's the paper you should be writing and giving to Theresa May. We'll give it to her through Latest TV if you want to write it over Christmas.
I'll be happy to do so, because, I mean, the thing is, we shouldn't be expecting low standards. You expect low standards are always going to slip.
Yeah.
I mean, when people come to my house in Brighton, they go, this is really nice.
Yeah.
And I mean, obviously, they pay a little bit extra to most people.
Sure.
But when it goes to most student houses, you've got damp, things hanging off the walls, holes in the walls, ridiculous animals, slugs, stuff like that. I've
so we need some real policies, which you're going to do. Yeah. George, have you got any policies now that will solve the housing crisis, make sure that young people can buy houses as well as rent them?
Well, we've recently just put in a petition to the full council meeting, which was to push the council on their own promise. They said on 15 units or more that 40% will be affordable homes. In the 2 and a bit years they've been in council, once they've hit the target. That's appalling. There needs to be a difference, and we got the petition there, and it's been pushed over to a committee that I still do believe it was not the housing, it was not the planning, it was the development and tourism committee, which has nothing to do with it. We need good housing in Brighton. I am fortunate because I do live in Brighton, I can live with my parents. Well, obviously, like you said, yeah, you came into Brighton to learn, because we are
becoming successful. So it is that you can live with your parents. I mean, I was brought up some while ago, but, you know, when I left university, or I was around 20 or so, I did manage to find somewhere to live, to rent easily, you know, without having to live with my parents. And then I did manage to buy somewhere, again, quite easily. I'm not going to tell you how much, because you'll kill me, you know. I mean, there's a lot of revenge of the millennials. But
that doesn't exist anymore, unfortunately.
But that's what we need back, don't we? Definitely. We need that opportunity. People have got to have the security, I think. Security is everything in life, I think. Mm. You need security, whether it's buying somewhere or whether it's having long-term rents. Isn't that the answer?
Yeah, I completely agree.
Can't we just put it in black and white in the law?
Yeah, that rent, I think, has to two things that should be prioritised is obviously building more houses. If you have a lot of people coming to the country, you have a lot of people wanting houses.
Of tenure as well.
I completely agree with that. I can't argue with that. I mean, people, if they want to rent a house,
somebody moves into somewhere, they should be able to stay there until they want to move, not until the landlord wants to throw them out.
I don't know, because it depends on the conditions. Obviously, if you've got a dodgy tenant, then you should be able to kick them out.
Well, of course, I understand that.
But I think 12 months, they should be able to.
It's like any reason they can just.
Well, yeah, I think there should be strong strengths on both sides.
Yeah.
I think if you're living in your conditions that are fine and the landlord says you can stay there, it's fine.
Yeah.
But there's certain times when the landlord's like, well, I've got this house, I've got a room for 6 months, you can take it for 6 months, I can't offer you any more. But that should be staged, and it should be very clear in that aspect. Things can change.
I think they should be 6 years or 5 years minimum, myself.
I mean, sometimes you don't know what's going to happen in a few years' time. What happens if an economic boom occurs and you want to sell your house?
I look forward to seeing your policies in the new year.
It'll be interesting. Another thing I want to make clear is a lot of students expect something for nothing these days.
Yeah.
I mean, I've always worked. I work night shifts. I work Friday, Saturday nights.
I know you
find another student who'll work Friday, Saturday night shift.
Yeah.
And I'm talking 9-hour shifts.
Yeah, sure.
I finish at 6 in the morning and I'm working all the next week, all this week even. All week, every single day, to work night shifts.
We'll see if we can get Callum Kant from Navara, from Acorn on in the new year, and we'll have you on then to talk. That'll be an interesting debate. George, housing's obviously a massive issue in Brighton for young people. What are the other really big issues that young people are concerned about and that they want solved by Ed and his mates?
Use that term loosely.
Yeah.
I think you could just say there's a lot of issues that do affect young people. I think everything does. I think every little bit you see.
What about student fees?
Oh, God.
What are you going to say?
I think you've got to say it's happened and we did make a mistake. And that is the one thing where you've got to look at our own party, and we admit that what we did then was wrong and we should not have done that. I think we now need to move past it, and I believe, well, that's something the party actually needs to address.
Is it right that university vice chancellors are getting £300,000 or £400,000?
No. Especially when you've got.
Hasn't the student fees thing only really benefited the people who teach at university?
No, not at all.
And not the students.
One thing, Sussex University, tuition fees have gone up. 40% of tuition fees goes to help those in lower economic backgrounds.
Okay.
So minorities, so they can have scholarships, they can have grants, they can benefit them. And that's one thing people forget. Also, the tuition fees, actually the best loan you'll ever get. I think it's £25,000, now it's been increased, you start paying it back. The interest is extremely low.
Do you defend
I completely defend it to my core.
What do you think when people leave and they've got, you know, £50,000 working for Deliveroo?
It doesn't affect your buying a house.
Okay.
It doesn't affect anything like that. That's one thing. An ordinary loan,
it's
it would
be something
do.
You can forget about until you get a
good job. You can essentially
job.
Forget about it until you pay for it.
You've got to have a lot of nerve it will to forget
be,
about it.
It'll be over your mind all the time.
It could be on your mind, but that being said, you don't contribute to it. You're not forced to pay for it, and after 25 years, it's already wiped away. Okay. I think there's problems with it. Don't get me wrong. I also think STEM subjects, they should be subsidised, if not free, because that's what the government want. I think we should also push universities who excel in certain subjects. Students who go there and attend these subjects should be subsidised. But that being said, I think if you want to go to university, you should pay a fee. But it also helps benefiting those from lower backgrounds.
Okay. We've not got a lot of time left, maybe a couple of minutes. So what do you think are the big issues then that young people particularly are concerned about in UK politics?
I definitely think housing, but that's already been discussed.
Yep.
I think income and paying taxes is very important as well, because
you want to see it removed completely
from people,
20 grand?
A regional diversity. I don't think 20 grand, because
how much?
Well, you don't know number, because one, different people's circumstances are different.
Yeah.
A person who's single but got a child, circumstances are completely different from me.
Yeah.
And that being said, I'm currently trying to create a help to buy, start saving for a deposit for that. And that's a great way for people to buy houses.
Yeah.
£5,000.
Yeah.
And that's going to be able to be a first push to buy a house.
You're
going to
do that, are you?
I'm going to do that. I'm going to save. And that's the thing.
We'll talk about that more in the new year.
You work and work and work.
Just under 40, 45 seconds left. So 20 seconds each. What do you want to see happen in 2018? What's your one big wish?
Hard Brexit.
Oh, jeez.
I knew someone would mention it sometime.
I want the referendum on the final deal of the EU. And I believe Theresa May should go as well.
Right. Oh, I agree with that, though. That's for sure. I'm definitely the last bit.
So Theresa May to go, you believe that too?
After Brexit, though.
So that's got to be 2019 or 20, isn't it?
Yeah. But we'll have to have a referendum on the deal first.
Definitely. It's not going to happen.
It will happen.
It's always nice having you two on the show, but that's all we've got time for this year. So thank you for joining us on The Vote.